Good morning, Eisenhower. We are broadcasting live from the ETV studio.
I'm your host, Emma, along with
Sarah. Today is Monday, April 17th, day B.
Today in history, on April 17th, 1971, the People's Republic of Bangladesh is formed.
You may be seated.
And now for today's announcements with
Bobby and Tyler. And Bobby.
Good morning. I'm Ryan along with
Tyler.
What does today's weather look like?
Cloudy early today with peaks of sunshine expected late, high around 70. Partly cloudy skies tonight, low 43. Tuesday will be sunny along with a few afternoon clouds, high 62. Now here's Ryan with today's announcements.
Thank you, Tyler. The Debate Club will be hosting a debate on climate change this Wednesday, right after school in room 506. It will feature VJ and 7K and Jonathan and 7M arguing against Kendra and 7D and Sarah and 7K. All members are expected to attend as judges, but spectators are always welcome. See Mr. W for details. Baseball tryouts will continue after school today. The Wyckoff Public Library will be showing the movie Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them next Wednesday, April 26th from 4 o'clock to 6 o'clock. Monroe Room. Snacks will be available. Register online or at the library. Here's Tyler with the rest of the day's announcements.
Thank you, Ryan. The Animal Welfare Club is selling Good Luck Charms for the park to raise money for the Bergen County Horse Rescue, an organization dedicated to rescuing and rehabilitating abandoned and abused horses. Good Luck Charms are horse-shaped chewed chocolates that can be sent to friends, students, or yourself for good luck on the park test. Similar to candy grams, orders are placed during lunch and the candy is delivered during homeroom. Each bag of Good Luck Charms costs $1 and they will be delivered on Wednesday, April 26th. You can order them from Monday, April 17th through Friday, April 21st. Park testing will begin for 8th graders this week. The first day of the testing is scheduled for Wednesday. Is Eisenhower celebrating any birthdays today?
Eisenhower wishes a happy birthday to Ava in 8H, Philip in 6B, and Colin in 6F. What's in the headlines? Or what's for lunch today?
Today's lunch is all white meat chicken parmesan sub. What's tomorrow's lunch?
Tomorrow's lunch is nacho grande with black bean salsa and Mexican rice. What's in the headlines?
Tensions over North Korea's nuclear program grew over the weekend. A North Korean missile blew up almost immediately after her launch on Sunday, and President Trump and his aides warned that the U.S. was losing patience with North Korea. And now for today's feature with
Lily
and Elizabeth.
Thanks, Ryan and Tyler.
Have you ever heard of Model UN?
I don't know much about it, but I heard they just came back from their trip in New York City.
Let's go watch this feature on Model UN.
Hey there, Eisenhower. I was just going over my notes for the Model UN trip. For those of you that do not know, Model UN is an after-school club that meets on Tuesdays and Thursdays discussing international issues that are affecting the nations of the global community.
Each member of the club gets assigned a country of the United Nations that is being impacted by an international issue. The members then further research how their country is being affected by this problem and participate in conferences where they represent their nations in discussions on these global issues. Upcoming for the club is their annual trip to the Model UN Conference in New York City, where middle schoolers from around the world will come together to discuss international issues affecting the global community.
What country and committee are you representing for the Model UN Conference, and what is the global issue?
So I'm representing the Republic of Yemen, and my committee is UNDP, and the global issue we're dealing with is Sustainable Development Goal 16.
How have you prepared for this conference?
So I've been keeping up with news articles and reading a lot of background guides about my issue and my country.
What are you most excited about for the trip and why?
Well, Shauna, in MUN we get to really get in deep into like world politics. Like for example, I'm Yemen this conference and I'm gonna get to learn about all the things that are going on in Yemen, like starving and death.
Why did you choose to apply to this trip?
That's a great question, Sean. Well, three reasons. One, MUN is fun. Two, you get to meet a lot of new people. And three, it's just a great experience.
What country and committee are you for this trip?
Yemen and SACUM on the topic of treatment of women.
How do you think the kids will benefit from this trip?
Well, the trip in particular to New York City, first off, gets them exposed to kids from all around the world, quite literally. Last year, we had students from Chile and Spain and Ghana and South Korea and Singapore, and not just representing the countries, but actually from those countries. So to meet people from other cultures is a great thing for them, as well as give them the ability to talk from students all around the country and the globe and form compromises and argue their points and discuss global issues.
Well, it looks like students are very excited for this trip.
Wow, I learned a lot from that feature.
Tuesday's feature is on Eisenhower Trivia.
And now back to our hosts, Sarah and Emma.
Thanks, Lily and Elizabeth.
And now for the joke of the day.
What kind of crimes do trees commit?
I don't know.
Treason. Thanks for watching, Eisenhower. Have a magnificent Monday.
Bring it back!